Hello everyone, in this video we will be testing discrete time signal for its periodicity. Okay, now the procedure is same, only thing is we have to the equation for omega slightly changes here. Okay, now the discrete time signal, in the general representation of a discrete time signal, is given by x of n is the discrete time signal, right, is equal to a, instantaneous amplitude of the signal, into cos of omega n plus or minus phi. Okay, so this comes under the angle, fine. Now this is omega, this is a capital omega. Whenever we are representing discrete time signal, the omega will change here. Unlike our continuous time signal, what was x of t was a into cos of omega t plus or minus phi, right? Fine. Now here this is for continuous time signal and this is for discrete time signal. What is the unit here? It is radians per second, right? Whereas what is the unit here? Radians per sample, fine. Okay, so what was omega here? So this omega was 2 pi by 2 pi f basically, but what is f? F can be written as 1 by t, right? 2 pi into 1 by t, whereas here it is same, 2 pi omega is equal to 2 pi by, instead of t it is capital N, right? So fundamental period of a discrete time signal, we represented it with respect to capital N. So we have to put one more term, m, here, where this m is an integer. Unlike it was 2 pi by capital T in continuous time signal, whereas in discrete time signal it is 2 pi by capital N into m, where m is an integer. So why we need this one more variable called m? Just to make the fundamental period integer. Okay, so because for a discrete time signal, the fundamental period is actually integer. For example, if I give you an example of a periodic discrete time signal, so 1 2 3 1 2 3 so 1 2 3, so this is 0 1 2 3 4 5, and this repeats, this pattern repeats in the positive side as well as negative side, -1 -2 -3 -4 -5 -6, and this is 1 2 3 1 2 3, amplitude is 1 2 3 here and amplitude is 1 2 3 here, right? Now this is a periodic signal, right, and it is repeating after repeating this pattern. If I shift it right 3 times, the same pattern comes here, right? Right, if I shift it right 6 times, same pattern comes here. If I shift it 9 times, same pattern comes here, correct? No, but what is the smallest value of time for which the signal is periodic? It is 3, correct? No, so this is basically an integer. I cannot have like capital N, I cannot have like capital N as a fraction. I cannot have the capital N fraction, it's wrong. Capital N should be an integer. Signal won't repeat after 3.5 number of samples, right? It does not make any sense. So capital N should be an integer. To make this capital N integer, we put one more variable called as small letter m. Okay, and mind you, this small letter m is an integer, fine. The approach to the problem is as usual. I have to equate our omega to the given problem's omega, and I have to solve for capital N. Okay, so we'll take up few problems. Now problem number 11. So we stopped at problem number 10. For periodicity of a signal, now we will continue with problem number 11. So x of n is equal to cos of 3 pi n, cos of 3 pi n, this 3 pi n is in the angle, fine. Now solution, so what is our aim here? I have to check for periodicity, right? So I have to equate this omega is equal to, what is the omega here? It is 3 pi, right? Because cos omega n, this is of the form cos of 3 pi n, right? So this omega is 3 pi basically, correct? No, now what is omega? Omega is 2 pi by capital N into m is equal to 3 pi, right? So omega is 2 pi by capital N into m is equal to 3 pi, where m is an integer, correct? No, so now you have to solve for n. So this pi cancels out, So n, if I take it in the left hand side, this becomes equal to what? So 2 by 3, 2 by 3. So 3 goes to the other side and m remains there. Okay, so listen here carefully. What is the smallest value of m? I repeat again, what is the smallest value of m for which the right hand side of this capital N is an integer? I repeat again, what is the smallest value of m for which the right hand side of this equation, the right hand side of this capital N, is an integer? Okay, we'll check it. We'll see that. For m is equal to, I cannot put m is equal to 0 because 0 does not make any sense. Fundamental period of 0 samples does not make any sense, right? So I have to start from m. For m equal to 1, whether capital N is an integer, so n is equal to what? 2 pi by 3 into n. So no, it's a fraction. For m equal to 2, whether capital N is equal to what? 2 pi by 3 into 2, this is equal to 4 by 3, this is also a fraction. So for m equal to 3, capital N is what? 2 pi by 3 into 3, this is equal to 3 cancels out 2. Now for m equal to 3, I get capital N is equal to 2, right? So for m equal to 3, what do I have? N is equal to 2 by 3 into 3. 3 cancels out, this is equal to 2. Okay, so therefore fundamental period for this signal is capital N is equal to 2. In the sense, after every 2 samples the signal will repeat. Fine. I hope I convinced you. Let me convince you with one more example. In this case, x of n is equal to cos of 2n. X of n is equal to cos of 2n. Now solution. So what is omega? Omega is equal to 2, right? So this is of the form cos omega n, which is equal to cos of 2n, right? So omega is equal to 2 here. Now what is omega? 2 pi by n into m is equal to 2. Now I have to solve for n. So n is equal to what do I get? 2 by 2 into pi into m, right? So 2 cancels out. N is equal to what? Pi into m. Now what is the smallest value of m? You have to search for a smallest value of m for which capital N, right hand side of this capital N, is an integer. Okay. Now you might thinking that for m equal to 1 by pi, if I put m equal to 1 by pi, so pi cancels out, I get n is equal to capital N is equal to 1. But this is wrong. Why? Because what is m? M should always be an integer. Okay. So I have to make sure that m is an integer. And what is the smallest value of m for which the right hand side of this equation is an integer? So if you check for it, there is no value of m, there is no value for m for which capital N is an integer, right? Because pi, what is pi? Pi is 3.142. So there is no value for the value of m for which capital N is an integer. So therefore this signal is non-periodic. Why? Because there is no value of m for which this right hand side of this equation is an integer. Okay. This is problem number 12 now. Next, 13th problem. So x of n is equal to cos of 8 pi n by 7 plus 2. Okay, so solution. So what is our aim? I have to check for periodicity. Fine, this is obviously a periodic signal, but I have to check whether what is its fundamental period. No, so what is omega? Omega is equal to 8 pi by 7. So forget about this. This is the phase. Phase has nothing to do with the periodicity, right? And what is omega? 2 pi by n into m is equal to 8 pi by 7. So pi cancels out. Solve for n. N is equal to what? 7 2s are 14 divided by this 8 goes to the denominator times m, right? So n is equal to 2 7s are 2 4 is 8 into m. Correct, no? Now what is the smallest value of m for which capital right hand side of this equation is a integer? For m equal to 1, it's a fraction. For m equal to 2, it's a fraction. For m equal to 3, it's a fraction. Whereas for m equal to 4, 4 cancels out, I end up with 7. So for m equal to for m equal to 4, I get n is equal to 7. So this signal is periodic with fundamental period 7. In the sense, after every 7 sample, the signal will repeat. Next, 14th problem. X of n is equal to cos of 0.1 phi into n. So solution. So what is omega? Omega is 0.1 pi, right? And 2 pi, omega is 2 pi by n into m is equal to 0.1 pi. So pi pi cancels out. I end up with n is equal to 2 divided by 0.1 is 20 times m. So smallest value of m is, for m equal to 1, I get n as 20. So after every 20 samples, the signal will repeat. Fine. Next problem number 15. So we shall take up a signal where it has more than one frequency component. Cos of 2 pi by 5, cos of 2 pi by 5 into n plus cos of 2 pi by 7 into n. So as usual, the way we used to solve for continuous time signal, same thing. This, we have to find capital N1, we have to find capital N2, we have to check the ratio. If the ratio is actually a rational number, then the signal is periodic, otherwise signal is non-periodic. And to check its periodicity, I have to take LCM of N1 and N2. Okay, so solution, so we will try to solve this now. So what is omega 1 is equal to 2 pi by 5, right? And what is omega 2? So for this signal, and this is for this signal, omega 2 equal to 2 pi by 7. Now 2 pi by N1 into M is equal to 2 pi by 5. 2 pi, 2 pi cancels out. N1 is equal to 5 times M. Right? Now what is the smallest value of M for which the right hand side of this equation is integer? So for M equal to 1, so N1 is 5. N1 is 5 for M equal to 1. Smallest value of M. I have to search for smallest value of m. Okay, similarly 2 pi by n2 into m is equal to what? 2 pi by 7. 2 pi, 2 pi cancels out. I end up with n2 is equal to 7 times m. Okay, so for smallest value of m for which n2 is integer is m is equal to 1, n2 is equal to 7, right? So therefore n2 is equal to 7 for m equal to 1. Now so since both are integer, I have to check for n1 by n2 ratio, which is equal to 5 by 7. It's a rational number, therefore the signal is periodic. The signal is periodic. Now how to check its fundamental period? So we'll approach with the easy method where I have to cross multiply. So n is equal to what? N1 by n2, which is equal to 5 by 7. So if I cross multiply this, 7 times n1, 7 goes here, is equal to n2 goes here, 5 times n2, right? So what is the value of n1? 7 times n1 is 5, is equal to 5 times, what is the value of n2? n2 is 7. So both are 35, right? So therefore n, capital N, is equal to 35. So for every 35 samples, the signal will repeat. Okay, take up one more problem. Problem number 16, x of n is equal to e power j 6 pi n. So solution. So this is of the form e power j omega n, right? So what is omega? Omega is 6 pi. Now 2 pi by n into m is equal to 6 pi. Pi pi cancels out. Solve for n, 2 by 6 times m, which is equal to 1 by 3 times m. So what is the smallest value of m for which right hand side of this equation is an integer? So for m equal to 3, for m equal to 3, I get n equal to 1. So for every one sample, the signal will repeat. Okay, now problem number 17. So x of n is equal to e power j 2 pi by 3 into n plus e power j 3 pi by 4 into n. Okay, so e power j 2 pi by 3 into n plus e power j 3 pi by 4 into n. So solution, so get n1. So 2 pi by n1 into m is equal to 2 pi by 3, and 2 pi by n2 into m is equal to 3 pi by 4. Okay, so 2 pi 2 pi cancels out, n1 is equal to 3 times m. Here n2 is equal to pi pi cancels out, 4 to the 8 by 3 times m. Now n1 is equal to 3 for m equal to 1. For m equal to 1, I get n1 is equal to 3 and n2 is equal to 8 for m equal to 3. Right? And what is n1 by n2? N1 by n2 is 3 by 8. So since it's a rational, signal is periodic. Now what is its fundamental period? So n is equal to what? 8 times n1, which is equal to 3 times n2. So n is equal to, what is the value of n1? 8 into 3 is equal to 3 into n2 value is 8. So this, therefore, the fundamental period for this signal is 24. 3 8's are 24. Okay. So I'll take one last problem. So 18, problem number 18. X of n is equal to cos of 1 by 3 times pi n into sin of 2n. So this is under angle, this is under angle. So this is the product of two signal. So whenever you have product of two signal, you have to convert it to sum. But we have one more result. Whenever I have a non-periodic signal, when the non-periodic signal is multiplied with a periodic signal, then the signal, the combined signal is actually basically non-periodic. Okay. And sin 2n is here is a non-periodic signal. How did I say that? Because see, so what is omega? Omega is equal to 2, right? And 2 pi by n into m is equal to 2. 2 cancels out. What is n? N is equal to pi into m. So there is no value of m for which capital N is an integer, right? Because this is the pi. So basically this signal is non-periodic. Whenever a non-periodic signal gets multiplied with a periodic signal, the resultant signal is periodic, therefore non-periodic. Therefore this signal as a whole is non-periodic signal. Non-periodic